we are definitely missing on this. And that was that the patient's total protein was around 10.2. And albumin was 3.1, globulins were 7. Liver enzymes are all normal. So there is 10, 3, 7. Okay, then he said like, see, there is some kind of a problem. What is so big about it? He said, no, still this much of a disparity, there is a chance. We actually went and met the radiologist, and radiologist said that we are scanning through the images, and in one of the images he showed us that in the vertebra at the back there was an erosion, and in fact there was almost like a fracture, and fracture would have been the reason for pain, and we are wrongly treating it as a UTI, and we did a serum protein and a serum immune electrophoresis, and it was a IgG myeloma, and this lady was actually referred to the cancer center to the hematologist for treatment of multiple myeloma. You see, the patient would have been treated as UTI and again treated as UTI. It is just that thought of two things and connecting those two things which actually helped us to make a diagnosis of multiple myeloma. So the core is basically integration, and that is again what Edition 5 stands for. Clinical core, core clinical, and integrating everything possible in the system and helping you to actually clear the exam with flying colors. So this is a period of systole where the ventricle is contracting, the tricuspid valve is closed now, the AV valve and the semilunar valves will open soon. Now it is at this point that who is going to be contracting? The atrium is contracting. It's a very, very abnormal phenomenon. This Cannon waves, so, can be seen in two settings. One is called regular Cannon waves, which is basically an arrhythmia, all of you know. And second is irregular Cannon waves. Irregular Cannon waves. So this is the regular Cannon wave that you are actually talking of. This is a typical example of an AV NRT patient where you can see the giant A wave, but it is very, very regular.